Well, it's not Shakespeare in the Park, but tonight we bring you Shakespeare like you've never seen it before.
Well, Hamlet, for example, is a story of betrayal, deceit, love, and murder. And News 4 Education reporter Ann Steffens introduces us to some unlikely actors performing in a most unlikely place.
Nobody needs legroom. No, these are lousy seats. Danny Waller?
It's not the big time, but still a major production for these 22 students of Shakespeare.
I've never thought about doing Shakespeare, and it was an opportunity to learn.
It was a challenge for me, and that's what I wanted, was a challenge.
The language is very difficult, and it takes practice and it takes time.
Glad you could come.
Thus, conscience does make cowards of us all.
For their work, many of these men earn credit from Fontbonne College, paid for by donations. That's because none can afford it.
Derek Parks, 12 years, first degree champion.
I'm Edward Moss. I'm serving 15 years with 85% for armed robbery.
I'm doing a life sentence for a second degree murder.
Oh, hey, not a king.
They are prisoners at Missouri Eastern Correctional Center, just a step below maximum security, and they're working their way through one of Shakespeare's greatest tragedies.
In high school, I had to read Macbeth in the 10th grade, and I thought it was the most boringest thing that I ever read in my life, Shakespeare. When you get together and you actually learn the words.
And for the day confined to fasting fires, till the foul crimes done in my days of nature are burnt. You know, it's phrases like that to make me feel emotional.
Believe me, I cannot.
While the project is designed to teach teamwork and reading and culture, it's not the men the director wants to educate.
The changes I see are mostly in the audience members. I got a 4-page email from a friend today, and she said, I have always looked at prison inmates as a group. And I spent the whole time I was in the theater space saying, he doesn't look like a prisoner.
Dead foot ducking.
For 1 hour, the only thing held captive is the audience. In Pacific, Ann Steffens, News 4, St. Louis.
Very interesting story.
What a thou that you serve this time of night, together with that fair and warlike form in which the Baron Majesty of Barry Denmark did sometime march. By heaven, I charge thee, speak!
Now follows that you know young Fortinbras, holding the weak supposal of our worth, our thinking by our late dear brother's death, our state to be disjointed and out of frame. Colleagued with this dream of his advantage, he hath not failed to pester us a message. Important the surrender to those lands lost by his father with all bands of law.
Get here, Laertes, aboard the boy for shame. The wind sits in the shoulder of your sail, and you are stayed for. There, my blessing with thee, and these few precepts in thy memory.
Some say that ever against that season comes, wherein our Savior's birth is celebrated, this bird of dawning singeth all night long. And then they say no spirits dare stir abroad. The nights are wholesome. Then no planet strikes, no fairy takes, nor witch hath power to charm.
If thou didst ever thy father love.
Oh, God.
Revenge is foul, a most unnatural murder.
Murder?
Murder.
Murder most foul is in the best it is. This most foul, strange, and unnatural.
Thank you.
my debut. I'm happy, I'm proud.
He gets the biggest one, that's all we're going to say.
Tally ho.
Ophelia, Hamlet wants to get with you tonight. Ophelia, I'm her daddy and that ain't right.
Answer me. Standing up, fold yourself.
Long live the king.
Bernardo.
He.
You come most carefully upon your hour.
'Tis now struck 12. Get thee to bed, Francisco.
For this relief, much thanks. 'Tis bitter cold and I am sick at heart.
Have you had quiet guard?
Not a mouth stirring.
Well, good night. If you meet Horatio and Marcella to arrive with my watch, bid them to make haste.
Give you good night. I think I hear them now. Stand ho, who is there?
Friends to this ground.
And liegemen to the Dane. What? Has this thing appeared again tonight?
I have seen nothing.
Horatio says 'tis but our fantasy, and will not let belief take hold of him touching this dreaded sight twice seen of us. Therefore, I have entreated him along with us to watch the minutes of this night, that, if again this apparition come, he may approve our eyes and speak to it.
Tush, 'twill not appear.
Well, sit down a while, and let us...
There.
Let's go back.
Yeah, you see what I mean? Because he didn't turn to see.
I understand.
See?
Yeah, he's coming on this side.
I see, I gotta come. No,
okay.
Yeah, okay.
And Robert?
God, you still got it in me.
I'm really sorry.
Would you hold that one?
I'm really, really sorry.
It weighs me still. Go on, I'll follow thee.
You shall not go, my lord.
Hold off your hand.
Be rude, you shall not go.
My fate cries out and makes each petty artery in his body as hearty as the Nemean lion's nerve.
Still am I calm. Unhand me, gentlemen.
By heaven, I'll make a ghost of him that lets me. I say away.
He waxed me desperate with imagination.
Let's follow. Does not fit thus to obey him.
Have after. To what issue will this come?
Something is rotten in the state of Denmark.
I think it was wonderful. I learned a lot. I'd like to thank the camera crew that came out. I'd like to thank Agnes and the rest of my supporting cast.
I think he foolish for me.
To be or not to be, that famous line from Shakespeare's Hamlet, is helping inmates at a local prison earn college credit. It's all part of a unique program called the Hamlet Project. Education reporter Sharon Stevens takes us inside the prison at Pacific, front and center at tonight's rehearsal.
To be
or not to be,
that is the question.
These are not your traditional Shakespearean actors.
The king, your TV, the king.
They are inmates at the Missouri Correctional Center at Pacific. Half of the 31 actors, such as 36-year-old Manuel, will be collecting college credit for their performances.
There are a lot of creative people here, and this is our way of saying I can do more than just sit around and do time.
Director Agnes Wilcox coaches a group of inmates through an act of Hamlet every quarter. And Fontbonne College will provide 3 college credit hours per semester. Their part of the program began just this year.
They're working roughly the amount of time that we would normally expect students to work both in class and out of class.
The organizers say the point of this exercise is to get inmates to learn, to explore, to have an adventure. And for those who are interested, to pick up some college credit along the way.
The Hamlet Project is an outgrowth of the Prison Arts Program founded by Agnes Wilcox.
For some of the men, it means they'll finish their degree. For some of the men who don't have their GED, it's an impetus to finish the GED.
In this environment, we really don't have much opportunity for anything except religious programs or recreation. And this actually gives something to stimulate the mind.
For in that sleep of death, what dreams may come when we have shuffled off this mortal coil?
Sharon Stevens, News Channel 5 on the Night Beat.